Well, Matthew, 1,000 games in the Elite League, how does it feel?
Yeah, it's crazy, to be honest. Like we just spoke just off camera, I didn't really know about it, didn't really expect it. Found out earlier this week. But yeah, it's cool. I mean, we lost tonight, which is rubbish. And, you know, not because it was my 1,000th game. Just, you know, you don't want to come on the road or go to, you know, home and lose a hockey game. This is a huge weekend for us. We really need to turn our form around. And, you know, tonight Dundee brought the game and, you know, took over and won 4-1. And that sucks. But, you know, 1,000 games is cool.
Yeah, going back to the start, did you ever envisage that you would do so much in your career and get to that stage where you have? Was that always an ambition? Or
no, of course not. I mean, my first games were for Cardiff when I was maybe 16 years old. The team went bankrupt and they needed younger local guys to play, you know, like myself. And I did. And I, you know, I just loved playing when I was a kid. I still love playing now. Otherwise, I wouldn't be doing it. And, you know, one season turns into two seasons and three into four and so on and so forth. And because I still love playing the game, I'm going to keep doing it. And as long as I can still influence hockey games, then I will do.
What's your secret to that? Of course, a long, prolonged career that some players don't have the opportunity to do. How have you managed to keep yourself in the position that you're able to do this?
Well, I mean, obviously it takes a bit of commitment, obviously support from my wife and my family, those things. You know, especially now I have a business outside of hockey, and my brother and my dad have, you know, committed to me coming here and them taking a bit more of the slack back in Cardiff. So, you know, those things. But then, of course, you know, every day practicing the right way, eating the right way, doing the right things in the summers and trying to stay as fit and as healthy as you can, you know.
And tonight, did you expect the introduction you got from both sets of fans? Of course, there was a little kind of presentation for you at the start. Did you know that was happening? Or?
Well, obviously on the way here, no, I didn't. And it was awesome. And I really thank the Dundee Stars and their organisation. I met the owner tonight and that was awesome. And I really appreciate that. So thanks to Dundee and thanks to the fans for, you know, that little thing at the start. I didn't know until I arrived at the rink. And then I met the owner and he said, look, we want to present you with a... I think maybe it's a bottle of whiskey, is it? Yeah, a bottle of whiskey. You know, he run me through a few little bits and it was awesome. And it was really, really nice, really classy from the organisation.
Yeah, and I suppose it shows the Elite League fans, you can play for different teams throughout the years, but it's, I suppose, a unique thing in hockey in the UK that all fans do show respect to players when they have these poignant moments in their career.
Yeah, no, that's awesome. And, that, you know, like you say, you know, obviously the fans here support them, the fans in Nottingham support Nottingham, so on and so forth. But really, we're all here just to enjoy the game of hockey and we want to win. Dundee Stars fans want to win. And tonight they, you know, they clapped for me for 5 minutes and it was awesome. And, you know, I really thank them for that.
I've got to ask you, what does the future hold for you, Matthew?
Well, at the moment, obviously we're here, we're in the middle of the season. We need to pick up our form and start winning hockey games for Nottingham. But I know, like, after hockey, when that finishes, I'm going to be back to Cardiff and on the building site, or maybe not on the building site, managing the company. So I've already sort of pre-planned my future and life outside of hockey. And I think actually the COVID sort of lockdown season, where we didn't play at all, kind of prepared me for what it will be like in the future. But for now, I'm still loving playing and I want to get through the season, hopefully win some more silverware, and then we see what next season. And it's a cliche, but I'm just going to take it one season at a time and see what happens for me.
Well, 1,000 games, congratulations, and best of luck for the rest of the season.
Thank you very much. Thanks, Dundee.